Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. As you'd seen by the title of this video, today's workout is all about the hamstrings with a little bit of glutes in there as well, but this workout is filled with my favorite hamstring focused exercises, and this entire routine is my go-to for giving my hamstrings all the love they deserve. So let's get into it. Starting off, we have stiff leg barbell deadlifts. Now, if you cannot do stiff leg for whatever reason, you can replace these with conventional deadlifts. I'd say Romanian deadlifts, but those are already programmed later in the workout, so just swap for conventional if you need to. You're aiming for 6 to 8 reps and increasing the weight each set if possible. Also, as I always mention in my workout videos, with your first main lift, don't forget to incorporate a couple warm-up sets prior to your working sets in order to get you closer to your working weight, and also just to make sure you have your form down and your body's fully ready to go. Next up is lying leg curls, best isolated exercise to work and strengthen those hamstrings in their shortened position, hands down. You can also use the seated upright machine if that is all your gym has, but if your gym does have the lying variation, use that. Now with these, we are aiming for 6 to 10 reps for 3 sets and increasing the weight each set if you can. So focus on driving your hips into that pad as you bring the weight up, and also try your best to control the weight throughout, not allowing momentum to take over by just swinging the weight up and down. A little tip to help with that is to not allow the weight to just smack down or touch down completely in the machine. So stop your reps just before, and it will help force you to control it better and also help keep tension on those hamstrings throughout the entire set. Now here are those RDLs I was talking about earlier in the workout. So we have standard Romanian deadlifts for 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps, and yes, again, aiming to increase the weight each set if possible. So with RDLs, you want to drive those hips as far back as you can while moving down with the weight, and once you feel your hamstrings are fully stretched, you will then come back up and repeat. Next up is a single leg high foot placement leg press for 3 sets of 8 to 10 reps per leg. It is important that your non-working foot is placed firmly on the ground. That will help keep you properly aligned and stable throughout the movement. Now, here we are using a high foot placement to further bias those hamstrings. And like I always say with the leg press, you are only going to go as low as you can while your butt can remain in contact with the seat. This will help prevent unnecessary lower back pain or strains and injuries. I would also recommend you to lock out the machine before switching sides so that you can easily get situated with your form before moving on to the next side and finishing off with your next 8 to 10 reps. Next up is a B-stance hip thrust for 3 sets of 10 to 12 reps. Now, I personally train hamstrings and glutes together in my weekly split. The reason I would still suggest to incorporate an exercise like this on a hamstring-focused day is because your glutes get a good amount of work in their lengthened position with a lot of these movements, and so incorporating a shortened position exercise like this for the glutes in there is an easy way to hit 2 birds with 1 stone and just round out some solid glute work training as well. So B-stance hip thrusts are actually one of my top favorite thrust variations to do, and they are also great for those of you who are trying to work on evening out glute imbalances. So what you'll do is have your non-working heel in line with the toe of your working foot. You want the working side to be taking on a majority of the load, and then as far as how you hold the weight, it's really up to you and what's most comfortable. There's a few different ways you can hold it. The way I'm holding it here works best for me, so just depending on what you're using for resistance and what's most comfortable for you. You may prefer to hold it this way, or you may prefer to hold it a different way. Last up is going to be stability ball hamstring curls. So the goal here is 12 to 15 reps each set for the 3 sets total. These are really great for burning out the hamstrings at the end of a leg workout, and that burn catches up with you real quick, I'll tell you that. So you'll just want to keep those hips high and then curl that ball in towards you and back out, focusing on using your hamstrings throughout, and you'll definitely know if you're doing it right. But that is going to be the entire workout, so I hope you enjoyed it. So if you do give this workout a shot, let me know down in the comments below or on Instagram. I would love to know how it went for you. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye, guys.